Students, today we'll start our new topic, do our next topic, methods of purification of organic compounds. As we know that whenever we do a chemical reaction, then there are some multiple products are produced. So we need to purify the organic compounds. And so there are various methods by which we can purify the organic compounds. And the method we select that is based on the nature of the compound and the nature of the impurity present in that organic compound. So these are certain common techniques which are used for purification. First is sublimation, second is crystallization, third is distillation, fourth is differential extraction, and the last one is chromatography. So let's analyze this methods and how you will determine whether the organic compound is pure or not. This could be ascertained by determining the melting point or the boiling point. If there is change in the melting point or boiling point, that means that is because of some kind of impurity present in the organic compound. The first method is sublimation. What is sublimation? Sublimation is the process in which the solid directly changes into vapor without going into its liquid phase. And in this method, this property is used that one of the either the impurity or the organic compound, either of one will be volatile. Okay. So generally, sublimation technique is used in which our organic compound is sublime, whereas the impurities are non-sublime. So that way we separate it. Next is crystallization. Crystallization could be used where there is difference in the solubilities of the compound and the impurities in a given solvent. So we will select a suitable solvent and we will exploit the difference in the solubility of the compound and the impurity, and we'll use this crystallization method to purify our organic compound. Next is distillation. This method is used when we have to separate, when there is a volatile liquid and there are non-volatile impurities. So this method will be successful only when there is the difference in the volatility of the compound which we are going to purify and the impurities present in it, or when the liquids they have sufficient difference in their boiling points. Okay, in that case we can use distillation method. It is simply the very simple method. We can use, like, this is the flask in which the impure sample is placed. Okay, then we will heat it. Then the volatile liquid will vaporize and will attach a cooling jacket. Okay. And the vapor will condense. And finally, we will get the pure organic substance. This distillation is further divided into two types. First is fractional distillation and second is steam distillation. So let's see what is fractional distillation. So suppose if the boiling point between the two liquid is very low. Okay, so as in our earlier case, instead of this liquid and non-volatile impurity, if you have two different liquids in which the boiling point difference is much higher. So suppose liquid 1 has a boiling point of 40 degrees Celsius and liquid 2 has a boiling point of suppose 80 degrees Celsius. So as soon as the temperature will reach 40 degrees Celsius, then all the liquid 1 will convert into vapor phase, whereas the liquid 2 will still remain in the liquid phase, and by condensing the liquid 1 we can purify. Okay, and we can separate these two liquids. But suppose if the boiling point difference is very low, less than suppose 10 degrees Celsius, one is having 40 degrees Celsius, another one is having 50 degrees Celsius, then the simple distillation method fails to separate these two liquids. In that case, we will use the fractional distillation method. So if the boiling point difference is low, then the vapors formed will in the same range, and finally when you are will be condensing it, they will condense simultaneously and you will not get the pure sample. Whereas in the fractional distillation technique, we will have a fractionating column. Okay, we'll have a fractionating column where the liquids will condense, okay, according to their boiling point. So vapors of the liquid with higher boiling point will condense before the vapors of the liquid with lower boiling point. Okay, and the vapors rising up in the different fractionating column become rich in more volatile component. So as the vapor will rise higher, so it will have the more volatile component, and the one which is having low boiling point will condense, and finally the vapors of the liquid, they will separate in the fractionating columns, and finally you can remove the impurities out of it. So this is the diagram, right? You will just heat the liquid, will convert into vapors, the vapors will rise up higher, the one which is having lower boiling point will condense, the other more volatile will rise up higher, and they will keep on condensing, and finally the more volatile compounds will be at the higher range of this fractionating column. In this way you can separate or you can remove the impurities when the difference of the boiling point is low. Second is steam distillation. This technique is used to separate substances which are steam volatile and are immiscible in water. What do you mean by steam volatile? Right, when you pass steam in it, and it will become volatile. Okay, after condensing it, it will not be soluble in water. It will be immiscible, not soluble in water. So you can condense and collect it, and this way you will separate the impurities from the organic compound. So we'll use the mixture of steam and the volatile organic compound. Simply just take the sample, the water, then heat it, and in the mixture you will get steam and the volatile organic compound, and then we'll condense it, and finally after condensing, the liquid will be separate and the water will separate because they are not miscible. And then by using the separating funnel, you can separate the compound from the water, and this way you will get the pure organic compound. Next is differential extraction. Differential extraction, this method is used when the organic solvent and the aqueous solution, they have different solubility, right? They are immiscible with each other, so that they form two distinct layers, so that they can be separated using a separating funnel. As in case of water and oil, the oil floats over the water, it does not get dissolved in water, and the oil and water, they will form two different layers. So here the organic compound in aqueous layer is there, then you will put a solvent layer. So now there is solubility difference of the organic compound in aqueous solution and in the another solvent which you have used. So now the organic compound from aqueous solution will migrate to the solvent which we have used. So the organic compound is more soluble in this solvent, so it will migrate to that side. So finally this aqueous layer is there, just open this knob and the aqueous layer will be removed, and then finally we get the organic compound in the solvent layer, which can be later on extracted. Next method is chromatography. So chromatography is a very important technique, extensively used to separate mixture into their components or purify compounds, or also to test the purity of the compounds. Basically, we try to separate the mixture into their components, and by using that you can just purify the compound or you can just test the purity of the compound. So in this technique, the mixture of the substance is applied on a stationary phase, which may be a liquid or a solid. A pure solvent, a mixture of solvents or gas, is allowed to move slowly over these stationary phase. The component of the mixture, they get gradually separated from one other because of their different solubility. Okay, and this moving phase is known as mobile phase. So basically there are two different phases. One is stationary phase, which is a liquid or solid, over which we are passing the mixture, which may be the mixture of solvent or a gas, moves slowly over this stationary phase, and they gradually get separated from each other because of their difference in the diffusion or the solubility. Okay, this moving phase is known as the mobile phase. So based on the principle involved in the chromatography, we divide chromatography into two categories. One is absorption chromatography and other one is partition chromatography. First is absorption chromatography. So it is based on the fact that different compounds are adsorbed on the adsorbent to a different degree. Please note, it is not absorbed, it is adsorbed. Okay, so what is the difference between absorbed and adsorbed? Adsorbed with the spelling AB. The simplest example is like, take foam, dip it into water. So water molecules will go inside the foam. So it is, the water molecule is being absorbed, B. They go inside the medium. It is absorbed. Adsorbed is, now take this foam and put it over the chalk powder. Then the chalk powder will be just on the top surface of the foam. That is the adsorbing medium. So in case of adsorption, the particles, either the solid particles, the liquid particles, or the gaseous particles, okay, which is being adsorbed, they will be only on the top of the absorbed medium. Okay, whereas in absorption, it will go inside the medium. So in adsorption chromatography, we use this technique because different compounds, they have different absorption potential. They are absorbed to different degree on an absorbent medium. Okay, so commonly used absorbent are silica gel or alumina. Whenever you will purchase any new water bottle or something, then you will find a packet of silica gel inside it. Okay, why that packet of silica gel is put in that bottle? Because silica gel, that they absorbs the moisture of the air present in the bottle, and when they will absorb moisture, so it will prevent the growth of fungus, because whenever there will be moisture, there is a possibility that fungus will grow and it will give the foul smell. That's why we use silica gel. So when the mobile phase is allowed to move over the stationary phase, that is our absorbent, then the component of the mixture will move by different distances over the stationary phase, that is our absorbent. Why? Because they have different degree of adsorption. Okay, so they will move to a different distance over this stationary phase, that is our absorbent, and this way they will get separated. So there are mainly two types of chromatography techniques based on this principle of differential adsorption. First is column chromatography and second is thin layer chromatography. This is based on this differential adsorption. The components of the mixture, they have got different ability to adsorb on the medium. So first is column chromatography. So in this, the separation of the mixture will be over the column of absorbent, that is our stationary phase, packed inside the glass tube. So inside the glass tube, we will just place our absorbent medium and then we'll put the mixture Okay, and they will have the different absorbent capability, and by that it will be separated. So just see the example. Okay, so this is our absorbent medium. This is the stationary phase. Then we have the mixture of compound A, B, C. There are three, and we have put the solvent over it. So the mixture of the compounds, they will start migrating. They will start being adsorbed in this stationary phase, and because of their different absorption potential, they will move to different distance, and this way they will get separated. A, B and C, they move to different distances and they get separated. So this way their different absorption abilities is used to separate them. Next is thin layer chromatography. It involves the separation of the substance over the thin layer of an absorbent coated on the glass plate. So in this case, we'll take a glass plate which is coated with the absorbent medium, then we'll just put it over the solvent. Okay, and this is the sample dot, and it will move to different distance. Okay, so this is the thin layer chromatography being developed, and this is the full developed chromatography. Okay, so the solvent molecule, they have moved from the baseline by a distance of y, whereas the sample dot, it has moved to a distance of x. Okay, this relative absorption of each of the component of the mixture is expressed in the terms of retardation factor RF, which is equal to this x over y, that is the distance moved by the substance from the baseline over distance moved by the solvent from the baseline. And this way the component of the mixture, they get separated. Next one is partition chromatography. Partition chromatography is based on continuous differential partitioning of the components of the mixture between stationary and mobile phase. So paper chromatography is one of the type of partition chromatography. In paper chromatography, a special paper, that is chromatography paper, is used. So in chromatography paper contains water trapped in it, which act as the stationary medium. As we can see here, so we have this arrangement in which the solvent is there, there is a baseline, we have got the spot, then there is the chromatography paper, and we have covered it with the jar, and the jar is covered with the cardboard. Okay, finally the spot will move, and these the solvent, they will start moving from the baseline, and by this we can separate the mixture based on their differential movement. Okay, let's do the revision check. So what you should be able to do, first of all, why purification of organic compound is required? Okay, because impurities are obviously, they are not desirable. Whenever we are doing any chemical reaction, then these impurities could interfere. Okay, secondly, how we are selecting different methods, and what are the different methods of purifying organic compounds? Like first of all, we did sublimation, then distillation, fractional distillation, then differential extraction, and lastly chromatography we did. Okay, thank you.